Faith members, I welcome you back from that wonderful short break. We are right back here again to proceed with our lesson. We are now moving on to lesson 14 of week 8, and I call upon your maximum cooperation. So previously we have been looking at ways how plants with weak stems climb others, and we looked at three methods: by use of thorns or by using thorns or hooks, by twining or clasping, by using tendrils. So right here, we want now to look at of what importance are stems to plants. Of what importance are stems to plants? In our point number one, we are looking at stems store food for the plants. Some stems store food for the plants. We can even have an example, or we can have examples of some of the stems that can store food for the plants. We can have them here. Examples: we have Irish potatoes. They store food for the plant. And even we have a sugarcane plant, a sugarcane stem. Sugarcanes, the stems of the sugarcanes store food for the plant. Okay, so these are some of the examples of stems that can store food for the plant. Some stems transport, water and food for the plant. Stems transport food and water for the plants. Then our point number three, some stems or stems support branches and leaves. Stems support branches and leaves, because you know very well that branches and leaves are attached to the stems. Without a stem, a branch cannot be fixed, cannot stay there upright, can't stay on a plant. A plant must have a stem such that a branch can be fixed firmly. And stems make plants to stand upright. As we looked at this diagram here, maybe I can also bring it somewhere here. A stem makes a plant to stand upright. This is what we mean, upright. What we are talking about, upright, standing straight. So stems help plants to stand upright. Now, some plants with weak stems, in case they are not given support, they now, we call it a creeping. They creep, they fall backward, or they lay under the ground. Like now, passion fruits. In case they are not given a support, the stem can't climb or move or grow upright. You will find that a stem, instead of growing upright, will remain creeping down here. Okay? And this one here ends up making enough fruits to rot or to decay. So stems hold or make plants to stand upright. Having looked at now importance of stems to plants, likewise we have here importance of stems to animals or to man. How useful are stems to animals? How important are stems to animals? Be very attentive, children. Then we are saying some stems are eaten as a food. We always eat sugarcane stems, we eat Irish stems, there are very many. So some stems are eaten as a food, e.g. sugarcane stems, Irish potatoes, and so many others. Some stems provide animals with medicine. We get medicine from some stems. Examples: even lulusa, we can get the stems and then we prepare as medicine. We take as medicine to relieve ourselves from maybe from malaria. So some stems provide man with herbal medicine, and herbalists, they use stems to make herbal medicine. Then some stems provide building materials. We are all aware that we obtain poles from some plants. We get poles of different stems for fixing electricity, or for installing electricity, for even making fences, Okay? So we use poles for building houses, even installing electricity, and also for fencing our homes. Then another one, we have some stems can be used as firewood. You are all aware that even at school, wherever you are, you see people using cooking, using firewood. So some stems can be used as firewood. So after looking at all this, please, I want you to, you will have to answer some activity. It's a simple exercise for you here. You answer it, it will come along with this work in the hard copy that you are going to get at school. Remember to answer all the questions and retain the handwriting that you used in the previous work. The handwriting was very neat, and I wish you all the best. We meet next time.